YouTube, what's going on? Wanye Films back with another vlog. Today I'm going to be talking about how I shoot my music videos, the process, everything behind it, what goes down. Stick around, you don't want to miss it. So typically what I do is before I even meet up with the client, usually what I do is I sit down, I review the song, of course, before anything else, before I even go out to meet up with the artist. I try to come up with this visual storyline behind what I'm going to be shooting for the day, because not all the time, but most of the time, that's what you want to consider doing. Otherwise, you're just going to get out there in the field and be freestyling and going off the top. Not always is that a good idea, so it's best to always plan your shots. 9 times out of 10, they're gonna come out 100% better, giving you do the work before you even get to the location that you're planning to shoot. Make sure that you make a storyline. That's what I tend to do. If you don't have a story behind the video, that's okay too. You know, whatever you want to do is what you want to do. As long as you and the artist have an agreement, you can come together and form your music video however you want to do it. Also, along with that, you're gonna want to decide if you want day shots or night shots or even both. That's what I do before anything, given what type of song it is, what kind of mood it is. You're gonna want to figure this out. It's gonna make your job a whole lot easier. Upon arriving to the destination that you plan to shoot at, whatever the location is, that also is top key. You're gonna want to plan out your location before you even get to it, because you know, where are you gonna go if you don't have nothing planned out? So that is one good way to plan out your videos, is get the location down. And once you arrive to the location, you know, you're all the next step is you're gonna want to set up your camera. You're gonna want to get your settings right, get your lighting going. You're gonna want, if you're shooting at night or indoors where it's dark, you are gonna need some type of artificial lighting, or you know, lighting, natural lighting from windows or whatever it may be. You just need some type of light that's gonna improve your videos. You know, you won't have to bump your ISO up because you'll have enough light to work with. So yeah, get your settings right. That's what I tend to do. Whenever I wanna shoot, I always make sure that my settings in the camera are right before anything else. You know, before you even start shooting, before you even set up your lights, make sure that everything in your camera is set to go, your aperture, your ISO, and of course your shutter speed. You want all those things done first before you even do anything else. You don't wanna get those wrong. Your frame rate has got to be the right frame rate. You're gonna wanna get your camera settings on point first. All right, moving on. The next thing I typically tend to do is get performance shots. I do that even before B-roll. Performance shots are anything that is being shot in real time, anything 24 frames per second. This part of the video right here is for when artists are performing their music. So what separates performance shots from the B-roll is basically the B-roll is just like your storyboard. What you have come up with as a story, as opposed to the performance shots. The performance shots are the artist performing their song. Yeah, that's as simple as it gets. Performance shots, I do that in 24 frames per second, mainly with 4K. And then for B-roll, I just drop it down to 1080p for 60 frames per second, or even 120 frames per second. One day I would love to make a music video with just B-roll. That's probably something that I will do in the near future. If it comes down to it, I want to start getting more creative. I mean, you see this in a lot, like I've seen Kanye West do it. Well, someone recently, I can't think of who it was, but I just seen a video recently. It's just all B-roll. No, you don't see the artist performing. Joyner Lucas does it a lot. He had a money one. He had one about money. I can't think of it right now. I think like $100 bill or something like that. That's all I can think of. But look it up if you are interested in checking it out. Joyner Lucas. You know, just type in Joyner Lucas, $100 bill. I'm sure it'll pop right up. Dope video. Just whoever was behind that one was a mastermind at heart. But yeah, I would love to do that one day. I will do that one day. And moving on to the next step, B-roll. Your videos will not give off a story without B-roll. So you're gonna want a lot of B-roll. Right here, you'll see where I was downtown Hartford getting some B-roll for an up and coming music video that I was shooting. I'm not done shooting this video, but I figured I'd show some B-roll off to show you guys. I do have another shoot for this video. Right here, we were downtown Hartford at a skate park. And, you know, I just got some low shots of the artists as they're walking. You know, anything related to the video is going to be your B-roll. As I mentioned a couple of minutes ago, 120 frames or 60 frames per second is going to be idle for slow motion. And that's with any video you plan on shooting. Next, angles. You want your composition on point. That goes along with getting everything you need for the video is what I typically tend to do when I'm out and about shooting. When I shoot music videos, I make sure that I at some point bring some type of props into the video. It, you know, it improves your videos, and props can be anything, you know what I mean? Props can be money, guns, whether they're real or fake, whatever it is. These props will help your video. It'll make your video stand out. And that's what I tend to do, is I like to get some type of props. Cars are props too, you know. Put some cars in your scenes. Anything, you know, anything you can think of that will improve your video. So don't leave anything out. This is key to music videos for sure. Bring props, they're gonna help. Fog, you know, bring the fog machine in. Lighting, all of it comes together like a puzzle. All these things that I'm mentioning will fit together like a puzzle. As long as you are shooting in the right frame rate, and you know, you're getting those good angles, you know, your lighting's on point, your props are where they're supposed to be and being used the way they should be, your music video will come out good. You know, editing is another key factor. You got to know how to edit. And by that, I mean, you make sure that you're editing into the beat, make sure, or the words, whatever it is. I always try to edit to the beat. These are good things to know. You know, you're going to want to edit to the beat. You're going to want to make sure that you have a good color grade on your music video. And like I said, all this stuff comes together like a puzzle, and the finishing results are very pleasing. Sometimes I like to bring people with me to, you know, get another point of view, or get me, you know, doing behind the scenes or whatever it is that we do while we're out there. Behind the scenes are very crucial, because you want to give your audience some type of pass behind the scenes. You know, they want to see what's going on. You know, if you're just showing a music video, that's cool, they get to see the music video, but how dope would it be to get behind the scenes also? Any great director will tell you that behind the scenes will help you grow as a director. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I wanted to let you guys know how it's done, how I do it. You know, how I do it might not be the same as he does it or he does it, but this is how I do it. And you know, it might not even work for you, and vice versa. What you do might not work for me, or it might work for the both of us. Don't let anybody tell you can't do it, because you can. And you can, you know, art is your vision, you know, it's your vision, it's what you want to do. It's as simple as that. So yeah, guys, that's it for right now. I'm gonna wrap this up. If you like this vlog, go ahead, give me a like. Also, subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out, guys.